morning students. Today we are starting our first online class in computer for class 5. Our topic is evolution of computer. What do you mean by evolution? The gradual development of something. We know the computer has become a basic necessity nowadays. Can you imagine a life without computer? Now, we can't imagine a life without computer. Computer become a basic necessity of our daily life like school, office, hospital, railway, etc. But once upon a time, there was no computer. The computer was not invented. It is a very important invention. So students, it is a very long story. Let us start the history of computer. Computer truly came into their own as great invention in the last two decades of the 20th century. But their history stretches back more than 5000 years to the abacus. Do you know who is the father of computer? Charles Babbage. Charles Babbage is the father of computer. The term computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. The computer is a versatile calculating machine that can handle the different tasks at a time. In 1830, Charles Babbage invented a machine. The name of that machine is analytical engine. You can see in this image. The analytical engine contained ALU. ALU means arithmetic logic unit, basic flow control and punch card. It was able to perform the basic calculation. Now, start generation of computer. Computer can be classified into 5 generations. Each generation lasted for a certain period of a time and each gave us either a new and improved computer or an improvement to the existing computer. Now start the first generation of computer. The period of the first generation is 1946 to 1959. You can see in this image, the computer of first generation used vacuum tubes as the basic components. The basic The computer of this generation used the machine code as a programming language. The main features of this generation were vacuum tubes, very costly, generated a lot of heat and AC is needed. You can see in this image, these all are vacuum tubes. Now, second generation. The time of second generation is 1959 to 1965. In this generation, transistors were used that were cheaper, consumed less power, more compact in size and faster than the first generation. You can see in this image, this is the image of transistor. The main features of this generation were use of transistor, generated less heat, still very costly and AC is also needed. Now, third generation. The period of the third generation is 1965 to 1971. In this generation, computer using IC, IC means integrated circuit, and replaced transistor based machine. The major advantages was size, with computers becoming more powerful, smaller and cheaper. You can see in the size, it is very small compared to the second and first generation. The main features were IC used, smaller size, still costly, generated less heat compared to the first and second generation. Now, fourth generation. The period of the fourth generation is 1971 to 1980. The computer of fourth generation used VLSI, Very Large Scale Integrated Circuit. Fourth generation computer become more powerful, compact, reliable and affordable. As a result, it gave rise to the personal computer, PC. The main features of the fourth generations were VLSI technology used, very small in size, very cheap, computer become easily available. Now, fifth generation. The period of the fifth generation is 1982 till date. In the fifth generation, the VLSI technology become ULSI, Ultra Large Scale Integration technology, resulting in the production of the microprocessor chips. Artificial intelligence included, like robotic, games playing. Some computer types of this generation are desktop, laptop. Thank you.